It's 11 o'clock. This is news from KSFO. I'm Larry Brownell. In a traffic mess where freeways 580 and 680 interchange near Dublin, the Highway Patrol now has the right-hand or slow lane open on 580 westbound, but they have to close it off and on to clear away the wreckage. Early this morning, there was a spectacular accident involving four tractor-trailer trucks and several other vehicles with loads of potatoes and cans of oil spilled all over the freeway. Elsewhere, about 11,000 people are being allowed to return to their homes around a train derailment in Miamisburg, Ohio. Another 6,000 people, however, are staying away from their homes because of a tank car leaking phosphorus. Attorney General Edmund Meese today received the final report of his pornography commission. The panel is calling for sweeping changes in federal and state laws to eradicate smut, which it says causes sexual violence. However, Christy Hefner, president of Playboy magazine, disagrees, saying there was violence in the United States long before sex magazines.
To understand that there's nothing that suggests there's a causal link.
The official state-run radio in Moscow says today the Soviet Union has decided to move families back into some of the villages within the 19-mile evacuation zone surrounding the disaster-stricken Chernobyl nuclear power plant. They're still mopping up in the Palm Springs area today following yesterday's shattering earthquake. Ed Gaines, the assistant disaster director of Riverside County, told us what they're doing this morning.
What we're doing now is there'll still be probably some utility outages and damage to their homes and to their mobile homes.
The Berkeley Fire Department report said a two-alarm blaze this morning at 3044 Sacramento Street caused an estimated $150,000 damage to an abandoned building. Cause of the fire is still under investigation. There were no injuries in the blaze, which was confined to the city-owned building. In the San Francisco coroner's office, reports it has identified a man killed in an explosion at a salvage company near China Basin as 27-year-old Michael Waygood of San Francisco. Waygood was cutting an abandoned service station gas tank with an acetylene torch on Channel Street when the explosion occurred late last night. Routine traffic stops Sunday morning in San Jose apparently has given Nevada authorities a lead to a ring which counterfeits thousands of the gambling tokens used in casinos. Police say they pulled over two Vietnamese men Sunday and found stolen merchandise in their car. Officers say they also found more than 1,700 counterfeit tokens for two Reno gambling houses, the Pepper Mill Casino and the Reno Hilton. But they say every casino in Nevada probably has been hit. And drinking water in the White House was cut off for 5 hours in the midst of a heat wave today when an alarm warned of the absence of bacteria-killing chlorine in the system. President Reagan was notified by the chief usher's office and was served morning coffee brewed from bottled water. Signs were posted promptly in the east and west wings warning staffers and others not to drink the water. By noon, however, preliminary tests by chemists indicated it was all right to drink the water now. Now, KSFO Sports. Assistant coroner's report indicated that University of Maryland basketball star Len Bias may have been freebasing cocaine when he died. Dr. Dennis Smith says today redness in the athlete's windpipe was caused by inhaling heat, evidence that Bias may have smoked the drug. The A's lost to the Boston Red Sox 8-7 last night, but they'll get another crack at them in Beantown today. Kurt Young on the mound, broadcast time on KSFO 405. Giants are back in a first-place tie with Houston after losing to Chicago last night. Mike Lacoste will pitch for the Giants today. KSFO News and Information Times, 11:04.
When the highway's calling, the man with the helping hand, the Chevy man can.
Now, the Wall Street Journal Business Report.
The stock market's having its ups and downs today. This is the Wall Street Journal Report.
Bay Area weather, morning fog along the coast should burn off by noon. Sunny skies predicted inland all afternoon. Highs from the mid-60s near the ocean to the mid-80s inland. Tonight, more overcast and fog spreading inland with lows about 50 degrees. Right now, San Francisco has 56. Marin has 59 degrees. Oakland has 56. San Jose has 69. I'm Larry Brownell, KSFO News and Information. And now more of the Bay Area's favorite music with Jeff Young.